Hello everyone. Today we are in the chapter 5 and we will discuss here about information gathering. Information gathering is means to gather information and from arts and science and many other facilities and scopes to gather and put the informations together to reach a result. Now, what kind of information do we need? Information about the firm or organization, information about some user steps, information about their workflow. Information about firm and organization can be policies, their goals, objectives, organization structures. Information about user steps can be authority relationship, job functionalities, information requirement, interpersonal relationships. Information about the workflow can be the workflow, method and procedures, work schedules, DFD, which is data flow diagram, or the flow charts. Where does the information originates? Now, first one is the primary external source, which can be the vendors, the government documentations, newspaper and professional journals. Now, second one is the primary internal sources, which are the internal informations, which can be collected by financial report, personal staff, professional staff, system documents and manuals, the users, the reports and transaction documents. Information gathering tools are review of lectures, procedures and forms, on-site observation, interview and questions. On-site observation, you need to send a man on the site and he will observe the situations. Interviews can be done with the staffs, and questionnaires is to give them a sheet of question paper and they need to tick mark on the questionnaires. This is the questionnaire section. First of all, we have to review the literatures, procedures and forms. After reading the literature and forms, we can have an idea. This is known as a review of procedural forms. We have already discussed about the basics of on-site observation. Here we have some types. First one is natural. A natural observation occurs in a setting such as an employee in a place is natural. Then contrived observation is a set of observation is placed like a laboratory, because if you are in the laboratory, you can monitor who is working and what he is doing on. So this is contrived, and if you working with the workers is known as the natural. Now, direct and indirect. Direct means you have to go to the place and observe it by being present, but indirect means you have mechanical devices like a CC camera and any other things that you can easily find the people are working or not. This is the indirect functions. Now, structured and unstructured. Structured. In a structured observation of observed looks for and record a specific action, and unstructured means that whatever we pattern all at a time. Structured means it have a rule and regulation, and unstructured means you don't have any rules and regulations to observe them. Now, observe obtrusive and unobtrusive. Obtrusive means that employees knew that they are being observed, and unobtrusive being that they didn't knew that. Interviews and questions are already I have discussed. Interviews, you have already knows what is the interview and how it is done. You can easily ask question to your staffs and get the results. And questionnaires are to give them some questions and they will answer it. The difference between questionnaires and interview is very important question for exam point of view. Questionnaires are economical and interviews are less economical, because in the questionnaires you don't have to spend much money, but in interview you need to spend much money. Those can be done in the same time, because you have only fixed 10 minutes for the question answering. You have 500 steps, and those 500 steps can give the exam in the same time. So this is time consuming, but interview is not. Now, chance of error, because everyone will not answer the right question answer in this section, but in interview they can do so. So those are the basic difference between questionnaires and important, which is very important question. Now have a snap of this one. Information collection tools. Here are some advantages and disadvantages of information collection tools. First is document review. From document review, you can have some advantages like this and some disadvantages like this one. Have a snap of this. Here is the observation section, and now the questionnaires and interview section. If you study the questionnaire of an interview difference in the previous slide, then it will be very easy to you to answer and attempt this type of questions. Okay, that's for today. Thank you.